Should we start aquaponics by a commercial or even a large-scale system? This is what we're going to see together in this video. So many people have large goals, you know, and that's good to have big goals, big aim, and to see yourself in a future where you will be able to grow a large quantity of food at home, even maybe to produce some food for the community, for your friend, for your family, for your neighbors, but maybe as well to produce a little commercial system, you know, a local commercial system where you are the local aquaponics farm, and people come to your farm to get some vegetables. That could be interesting. That's a very interesting project. Many people nowadays are thinking of retiring with this type of production. So that's why many people are interested into aquaponics nowadays. Again, I think it's very interesting. I am part of those people who want to go for larger scale aquaponics. But very often I receive some emails from those people who say, okay, I got 20 acres, I got this surface of land, I would like to start aquaponics, how do I start? I have the aim to produce this quantity of lettuce, vegetables, fish, whatever. Please help me to put the things together. Again, I think we need to have big aim, big goal, but we need to go there step by step. And for me, there is a big, big problem when I see people wanted to start from zero knowledge in aquaponics to producing a commercial, running a commercial farm. Obviously, in aquaponics, we are running with natural principles, but you need to understand them. You need to know how nature works. And if you want to go for commercial scale, obviously, the setup is going to be large, and it's going to induce some costs, right? You're gonna have some cost to put the system in place, cost to run the setup. And so all those things, when you put them together, you need to make sure you are doing the right thing for where you live, but also for yourself, right? You need to make sure you have the knowledge to do things properly. You need to make sure you have the knowledge to design things properly. So when I receive an email from someone who say, I have zero knowledge in aquaponics and I want to grow tons of food per week, where do I start? For me, the start is to start with a small backyard aquaponic system, such as the ones I have behind me, or you can build your own very easily. But to start with maybe 1 cubic meter of water, 1,000 liters of water, or even a bit less. But you know, don't start with large scale systems. The idea is that if you start with large scale systems, you're gonna probably make some mistake in the design of the setup, right? And you may think that things are gonna work in one way, but maybe they are not gonna work as you would like them to work. So in aquaponics, I have to be very honest, we don't use any pesticide. I mean, generally speaking, then you can do a few things to make the system a bit more easy to manage. But in a backyard aquaponic system, such as the one I have behind me, we use zero chemicals, zero pesticides. We don't treat the crop. And therefore, if there is a pest come in, it's going to affect the crop. But we work with nature, so we always got some predators to regulate the pests that can come around. Imagine in a big commercial system, if you have only lettuce, you have the pest that is coming, is spreading all around, you lose all your crop. So you need to think about those things, to keep them in mind. It's easier to start on a small scale and to have what we call a pilot project, a small system that you're going to run in the same way as the big idea that you have. But first you start small and you see if it works well. And if it works well, then you can go for a larger scale. But you never start a large scale project in something that you don't know. You have to start small. You have to prove that it's working. You have to prove that you are able to manage it. So you need to build skills. You need to build knowledge to be able to make sure that you will manage the system properly when it's going to be a bigger scale. So before building a big greenhouse with large aquaponic system, big filtration, it has some cost to do that. So before doing this, start small in your own backyard. You can start with an IBC system. I have some videos to show you how to do that. You can start with a little aquaponic system such as I have here. And what I really recommend you, if you have big goals, is to start small and to get the free aquaponics training to start with at a small scale and to later on go for bigger scale. So it's very simple, step by step. You still have your big goal, you know where you go, but first you want to validate that the technique is adapted to you first. You know, you're going to be able to work with it, and you're going to bring your knowledge to go to the next step, which is a bit bigger, and then you're going to go to the large scale setup that you wish. I hope I'm not gonna receive those emails again of, I want to build this huge setup, can you help me, when you don't have any knowledge. You can't do that, right? I really highly don't recommend it. Don't recommend anyone to go for a large commercial system before being able to manage a little aquaponic system at home. Because on the little system, you're gonna have the same type of issues as on a big one. So you must first start with this for at least a year, 2 years. 1 year is a good thing. If you can manage a system for 1 year, it's gonna build some serious skills in yourself, right? You're gonna understand how it works, understand the mechanism, understand the little problems that you can face, and you're gonna be stronger, and you're gonna have some really good knowledge, and then we can work together on your larger scale project. But don't come to me with some big ideas if you haven't done anything with aquaponics yet. So I hope this respond to your questions. Again, have access to the free aquaponics training, because it's free. Again, it's in the description of the video just below. And it's step by step to help you to build your own aquaponics system, to manage it properly, and therefore to start small. And after a while, you can go for a bigger step and to go for larger scale. But first, start small. I hope you enjoyed this video. If it's the case, give it a like. If you're interested by aquaponics, if you still have this goal of going for big commercial aquaponics system later on, subscribe to the channel, because I always give some useful information, I hope, to help you to grow your food in a sustainable way in your own backyard. And I see you in the next video. Bye-bye. Don't forget to get your free gift from this screen. You can also leave me a comment below the video, subscribe to the channel, and see my last video. I really hope to see you soon, and I wish you a fantastic success with aquaponics. Have a good crop!